Very happy sobering up now, but also starting to head home, so very excited about this the win. And, we did well, you know, to go to Pretoria and win in Pretoria is not easy, but for us we were always mentally prepared for it. We knew that we'd have to travel this year because of our light situation, and it was great. Everyone got behind us from the Cape. Unfortunately we couldn't be in front of our students, but all the support was massive, and we just want to thank them for doing the Green Mile and taking it up there with us and all that sort of stuff. So we always knew we couldn't host the final, so the guys had mentally prepared for that, and we knew we could beat Tikkies in Pretoria, so that's what we went and did. Our campaign was based on love and changing lives, and I can literally say we've changed lives. You know, the guys are in such a good space now. I mean, there were tears. Guys were literally crying, saying they'll never forget this. And if they can look back in 30, 40 years and say, well, I was the first to win it for UCT, that's something special.
Congratulations. You've worked hard, 4 years of playing, 3 in the finals, and finally making it. This shows that it's not a flash in the pan victory. This is a victory that you've worked for and that the whole club has worked for, and the old boys have worked for decades, in fact, raising money, supporting the club, the volunteers, the coaches, the physios, the psychologists. It's a huge team effort, and it's been consistent, and the fact that we've won says to the world that we're not just great at academics, we're not just excellence is not simply in the classroom, it's excellence across the board. We want to be the best university in many respects, and they're proving that we can be. So well done.
We just want to welcome Max Pass on stage to say a few words.
Ayo, are you still there? Rugby club, they've been playing Varsity Cup for 4 years, in the finals 3 times. They have managed to bring the cup home to us, and we're really proud of them, and I hope that you all feel that this is something that we can unite the campus around, and that they can be a rallying point for UCT spirit, for Ikey spirit, that we can also spread in future to the other sporting codes. We want to see the same thing in soccer, the same excellence in soccer. We want to see it in women's sports. We want to see it in hockey. This is just the beginning, and we're going to show that we're excellent in everything, not just academically. We want to be the best university all around. Professor Sedin, who's been responsible for student affairs and has been at all the matches, is going to hand over the trophy to the captain of the team.
For all your support, you guys, we've absolutely incredible. Thank you for backing us every Monday night. We really appreciate it. Also to the Ikey's Advantage guys, thank you so much for creating such great awareness for the brand. You guys have been brilliant. And this is for you guys, so thank you so much. Woo.
Thank you.
It's a dream, it's a dream come true. This is what we've been working for the last 8 months, and it's actually started to finally sink in. And it's just a dream come true. It's changed lives, all our lives. So just like to say thank you so much. I mean, without you guys, I wouldn't be half the player I am, and I wouldn't be half as committed as what I am. And it's just a pleasure having you guys behind me. Well, we would have loved to play here in front of our home crowd and in front of all the people that have been behind us all year, but unfortunately had to be there. And there was no windy Pretoria, fortunately for me. But it just made it a little bit sweeter when in there, to be honest.
The strength of Varsity Cup is that it's televised. Being televised and being shown at prime time, which is 7 o'clock, means you need television lights, and we don't have that at our stadium. So we had no option but to play away, but it's reinforced our commitment to building a new stadium with television lights, with high quality stands, and we're running a campaign to raise that. We have an alumnus, Neville Isdall, who's given us 7 million rand, $1 million, to start that campaign. And now we are hoping to raise the extra money needed. We still have to get permission from the City Council, but we're positive that we're going to do it for the next year.
It's so wonderful that in our first year, the IQs are in super fantabulous. We love you, IQs! Yeah! We're so proud of our boys that they brought the cup back home. It's absolutely amazing. The first time for Cape 4 UCT to win somebody other than Stellenbosch.
They did us proud. We were, had so much fun on Monday night. So happy right down here by the fields. It was amazing.
It's a great feeling, especially as a first year here at UCT. I think it's an amazing achievement and honour, and really very stoked.